Sedition will not be tolerated. This is Generation Stadia, giving you your daily dose of everything and anything Stadia related. And today's topic is everything you need to know about Stream Connect. So in case you don't know, Stream Connect is one of Stadia's various exclusive features that can only be done on that platform. As for what it does, Stream Connect allows you to send a copy of your current gameplay session to another player, where it gets incorporated directly into their game. Now, this may sound like a very normal and basic feature, but the truth is it's probably going to be the one feature that I look forward to seeing being used most. And if you're wondering why that is, well, let's break down some examples, but let's start with the most important one to me, and that's couch co-op play. So if you've been gaming since the N64 days or any other period in time before that really, you'd remember just how many games used to launch with local multiplayer. And over the years, you'd also have realized just how many games no longer support that feature. And the reason for that is because games have become much more demanding on the hardware they're running on. Many games that do include local multiplayer then have to sacrifice visual fidelity, and sometimes even have to lower the resolution in order to fit everyone on screen. Now with Stream Connect, that's no longer an issue because every player gets their own instance of Stadia to start playing with. This is something that's been shown off by Google, and they say they fully support it, but ultimately it's up to developers if they want to implement it or not. But essentially what that means is that any cooperative game or any multiplayer game really has no reason not to be couch co-op. There's no longer a restriction on hardware because Stadia itself will give each player an instance and then Stream Connect will stitch both of their views together. I really do hope that we begin to see the revival of couch co-op play now that Stadia is enabling a feature like this. But that's not all Stream Connect can be used for. In fact, let's start discussing another one, and that's a cooperative squad view. With a press of a button, you'll be able to bring up every other cooperative teammate's view on your screen in a picture-in-picture mode. And due to the fact that this is all done through streaming technology, it won't actually have any impact on the game running. The game doesn't need to render everyone's viewpoint as it's only streaming the viewpoint to each player. Now luckily, we do have an example of this in Ghost Recon Breakpoint. The trailer for Stadia actually teases the feature being included. And as you can imagine, this type of feature would really enable some cooperative experiences that couldn't be done anywhere else. The example I'll give for Ghost Recon is have one player be reconnaissance with a sniper way back, scoping out the area, and then using the Stream Connect feature to see what they're eyeing on their screen. I do actually hope that this feature will also work in multiplayer PvP because it would be a very interesting concept. Next up, let's talk about another use it could have, and that's asymmetrical multiplayer games. Now, if that term sounds familiar, it's because we've had quite a few experiences like it in the past, and one console actually dedicated to it. And that's right, I'm talking about Nintendo's Wii U. That is asymmetrical multiplayer, when players on one screen can have one experience, while another player on a different device or different screen has their own experience, but still affecting the main game. Another good example of this is Battlefield 4's Commander mode. That mode used to allow you to have an overview of the battlefield, call in UAVs, and tell your teammates where to go. And while the idea clearly didn't take off for Battlefield, I think the concept is very interesting. Now, some of you may be thinking about why would I care about a feature that clearly didn't take off past that era in gaming? Well, because back then, the games were restricted to whatever hardware they were trying to run on. In Battlefield's case, it needed to be able to run on a tablet. In Nintendo Wii U's case, well, that platform was pretty underpowered from the get-go. And although the Wii U is considered a failure, it definitely had some very good games on the platform that really took advantage of that feature. Now, with Stadia, there's no longer a restriction on hardware limitations, so asymmetrical gameplay can really blow up in a big way. There's a lot of room for creativity now. Imagine a top-down game like Command & Conquer. One player gets to be the general, and they're producing and upgrading units. And then make the rest of the players play from a first-person perspective right in the middle of the battlefield. That would be a great example of asymmetric multiplayer, and honestly speaking, I would love to play a game like that. There have been attempts at this concept, by the way, but as you can tell, they've always been limited by the hardware, and either one part of gameplay has been lacking or the other. Stadia once again is able to solve that issue because everyone has access to top-of-the-line high-end hardware. Now I hope that gives you a good idea of what Stream Connect can do, but let's quickly go over a few examples that Google themselves have given to developers. One example Google gives is a game of It, where the It player can then press a button and see the first person view everyone else is seeing, causing them to have to run to a wall or look at the floor. A very simple concept, but one that can easily be expanded on. Imagine it's an objective where you have to gain intel on the enemy. You get this objective, and then it grants you the ability to see where they are for a few seconds. Not only does it provide a strategic advantage, but it plays really well into the gathering intel narrative. The second example was being able to stream a different point of your render pipeline to a spectator than what the main player is actually seeing. Basically, what that means is that the person playing the game still sees their health bar, their mini-map, and all the rest of the HUD. While on the other hand, the rest who are spectating don't get to see that sort of information. This could really help in battling people trying to cheat. Or better yet, make it much harder for stream snipers to catch their favorite streamer while they're doing their thing. Now the next one they talked about has to do with the asymmetric multiplayer, and believe me, this is huge. They talked about being able to stream from one game engine to another. Now that's a huge deal because, back to the example of Command & Conquer RTS with first-person shooter elements, that would mean that the general commanding the armies from a top-down perspective could actually be playing on the Command & Conquer engine, while the players on the ground could be playing on the Frostbite engine to give them a feel like Battlefield. This would make gameplay for both players absolutely fun and feel proper like their own game and not just something that was hashed together. So as you can see, Stream Connect really has some serious potential to change the way we play in a number of ways. Be it through local multiplayer coming back from the dead, or providing different and unique opportunities to play in asymmetrical ways. I don't doubt that Stream Connect is gonna become a staple feature for Stadia and cloud gaming in general. And that pretty much sums up everything you need to know about Stream Connect. Now if you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit that like button as it really does help the channel out, and if you want more videos like this, be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell as well. I do apologize if I sound a bit tired this video, I am still getting over being sick and my voice is starting to go, but I didn't want to stop providing you with some good content. I also want to give a huge shout out to the Gen S community. We just crossed 500 subscribers and I'm trying to push for that 1000 before Stadia launches in November. And with the way that this community's been growing, I don't doubt that we'll make it there in no time at all. I'm grateful for your support, and I'm grateful that you take the time out of your day to watch these videos. Thank you. Now, if you want to get involved with the Gen S community any more than this, be sure to check out my Twitter for channel updates, join our community Discord to find players who are picking up a Founders Edition day one, and now I'll also be on Instagram if you want to follow me there as well. The links to this will all be in the description below and the pinned comment of this video. This has been Generation Stadia, giving you your daily dose of everything and anything Stadia related. And until next time, I'll catch you in the clouds. Peace.